Let's try a parlour game to get us started. One Victorian parlour game was called Taboo. You were asked a question and had to answer without using a taboo letter of the alphabet. Our taboo letter tonight is obviously N, so please answer the following questions without using the letter N. Matt? Name a tasty yellow fruit grown mostly in the Caribbean and Central America. In the Philippines, its name has been corrupted to bayabas.
Is it, a ba-a-a? I'm trying to think what's nice and yellow. Crisps. I'm going for crisps.
As a tasty yellow fruit.
Yeah.
So, no, the answer is guava. Oh. Is the answer we were
looking
for.
Oh, there is an answer.
There is an answer.
I've been playing this game wrong for years.
It isn't banana at all. The answer is guava is the fruit that we were looking for. In the Philippines, it has been corrupted to bayabas. Do you know what the Filipinos call bananas?
No.
They call them bananas. I could have got you with that one, had you fallen for it. Susan, what do you call a woman who looked after Victorian children whose mothers were social equals but couldn't be asked to do the job themselves?
Well, I would call them the help.
Which is nice, but not the correct term.
Well, then I would call them... You've got such a gaze, Sandy. It's like the eye of Sauron.
Sorry, but Sauron's got an N in it.
I would have said the nanny or a governess. Yes. I was essentially cajoled into that.
You were. So, not nanny, obviously, because how many N's have we got there?
At least two.
At least two. Also, not socially equal, the nanny. It's au pair.
Oh, no, I almost...
Yeah, been around...
Josh, how annoying, isn't it?
Start with your own. Oh, I was on the tip of my tongue there.
It's been around since the 1840s, the word au pair. Well, it literally means social equal, au pair.
Does it?
Yeah.
Have you met our social equal? She's really, really fit. He's only run off with the social equal.
So, nobody doing very well, but I'm relying on Josh to get this one right.
Watch and learn.
OK, here we go. What do you call a Roman Catholic religious woman who has taken simple vows of poverty, chastity and obedience?
Is it the au pair?
That is guava.
Oh, it's difficult, isn't it, now?
Yeah, not so quick with the answers now.
Tracy?
I'll go on then. None.
None.
Yeah. None.
No. So here's the thing. The answer is a sister. So a nun has taken solemn vows, but a sister has taken simple vows. It's a technical difference to do with the repudiation of property. So a nun's solemn vow repudiates property absolutely. A sister's simple vow allows her to reserve an interest. Hedging her bets, Josh. Hedging her bets, that one. Right, Alan.
Yes.
Name any of the digits in the common emergency telephone number. There's an emergency number which is 999.
Three guys.
But the common emergency telephone number is 112.
Is it?
Yeah. So you can use it on a mobile phone, even if it's locked or you haven't got a SIM card.
It has got N's in 112.
Well, I asked you to name any of the digits in the common emergency number.
Come on.
So you could have said two.
Oh my word!
Two.
Christmas, so Alan wins that one. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Well, please, come on, pick something.